What we want to do after a baby is born is we want to stabilize the child, make sure that there are no other organs involved, because there are other associated anomalies in some children. We want to make sure that there are no genetic issues that we need to address. We want to make sure all the other organ systems are as good as they can be and assess them if we have to. And then once that is done, then it's more a matter of scheduling the surgery.
We have identified some risk factors in patients who have single ventricle type of heart disease.
Certain forms of single ventricle may not do as well as others.
Since one has to utilize the well-functioning ventricle to do the job of delivering blood flow to the body, if that single ventricle in some way is not functioning well, or if there's leakage of the valve that leads into it, that could be a significant risk factor for reconstruction.
Many times there are other associated genetic abnormalities that we have to look for carefully. And these sorts of genetic abnormalities would provide incremental or increased risk for the operation itself.
If the babies are immature, premature, that can add significant risk.
One of the things that can cause a real problem is when there's blockage to blood flow from the lungs getting back to the heart.
An obstruction of blood flow coming out of the lung, that we know can result in poor development of the lungs and can add risk as well.
For many children with complex heart disease, there's blockage of the blood either going to the body or to the lungs. And there's a blood vessel called the ductus arteriosus, which connects those two arteries. Everybody has one, and it usually closes after birth.
You can keep that blood vessel open with a medication called prostaglandins. And so therefore, by giving a baby prostaglandins, you're actually replicating the same physiology that it had in the uterus when it was very stable to when it's outside the uterus.
So instead of having a child come in critically ill where there was nothing we could do, we can stabilize these children, do diagnostic procedures, and then have a stable child who goes for surgery.